Imagine having a backyard that looks like this. Absolutely stunning. Arcadia Station is an iconic farm and homestead near Glenorchy in the South Island. It's a pristine piece of our heartland and it could be yours. Jim Veint is selling his family station, a decision he has agonised over for years. So who might buy this famous property and will it stay in Kiwi hands? It's Jahan Kasanata.
There's a lot of freedom in a place like this. You can sit down and look around and admire the scenery and find just a sense of well-being.
For Jim Veint, there's magic in these mountains.
I've been very fortunate to spend a lot of my life here. I just realised last week that nobody else has spent more time at Paradise than I have.
Paradise. It's been Jim's home and his heart for 80 years, but not for much longer.
Sooner or later, age catches up, time catches up, and you have to move on.
Just an hour from Queenstown and tucked alongside Mount Aspiring National Park is a postcard in the making.
So where are we, Jim?
Well, we're right at the edge of Diamond Lake here. The property extends from Diamond Lake in the south to the Dart River in the northwest. And then on the east side, we've got forest.
And in the middle, Jim's sprawling backcountry station.
When did this property become part of your family?
Well, my parents owned the neighbouring property for 6 years, from 1943 to 1949. And in 1951, they bought this. And I used to think I was the luckiest kid on earth living in a place like this. And I've been virtually here ever since.
The jewel in this station's crown, a grand old homestead built at the turn of the 20th century using native red beech timber. The man behind it, a wealthy young Brit named Joseph Fenn.
He was a classic scholar from England. He called his station Arcadia Station.
In ancient Greece, Arcadia meant paradise, and this isn't far from it.
You can feel it today, can't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, keeps a smile on your face most of the time.
From the early 1900s, the Earnslaw brought boatloads of tourists to Glenorchy, and many of them travelled to Arcadia Station, paying 9 shillings a day to stay in this classy mansion.
It was always recognised as a very good tourist destination, even more so than Queenstown. In those days, people would come and stay in a place like this for 3 weeks. When you got here, you did things. You rode horses, you climbed mountains, you fished.
This incredible footage from 1960 shows Jim guiding tourists through the valley. He later bought his parents' land and built a life around farming these 250 hectares, breeding some of the best Simmental cattle in Australasia.
Well, we're right at the centre of paradise here.
But what really put Arcadia on the map was the arrival of the international film industry.
In the early days when they first started looking for locations, they'd get in a helicopter and fly to the South Island, and that's how they found this. It depends what's in fashion. There's the white snow up there and the green grass. There's the forest and there's the rivers and creeks and a lot of variety.
17 major films have been shot on this station.
Wolverine was here with Hugh Jackman and he was running naked across that paddock. Once we didn't get very close to see it. We've had the Narnia films, we've had Prince Caspian and The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe.
Rise, Sir Peter Wolfsbane.
But Arcadia's most famous outing...
Well, the Hobbit house was just in beside those trees.
...was thanks to Sir Peter Jackson.
Good morning!
The location left quite an impression on the cast.
I know when Sir Ian McCallum was Gandalf, He said this was his favourite place on Earth, so...
Wow, that's a pretty good endorsement.
Absolutely, yeah, yeah.
Not every shoot has been as idyllic.
Taylor Swift came here. There was a forecast for a really extreme storm. Trees were coming down in the forest, and there was more than 100 people in that forest. We could have almost had 100 people taken out in one blow. And I said to somebody once, you know, the headlines might have been Taylor Swift dies in paradise.
Paradise wouldn't be a bad place to die, and for Jim, that was always the plan. At 82, he still farms his own land, mainly by himself.
You never thought about retiring at 65?
Well, things were just quite comfortable and it wasn't difficult, and it was a pleasure to get up in the morning and go out and do something and try and keep myself fit and healthy and keep going as long as I could.
That changed a year ago when his partner Roz had a stroke.
Well, she was lying in bed beside me and I heard coughing noises, and I suddenly realised that she wouldn't answer me. She couldn't talk back to me. Then we rang 111 and we got a helicopter in.
The stroke affected Roz's movement and her speech. But Jim reckons, on the inside, she's still the same.
You better try some tea. She's a wonderful patient. If she has a problem, she giggles about it. You want a biscuit?
Yeah.
Which one would you like?
Yeah.
One of these ones?
Yeah.
Jim and Roz now live half an hour away from Paradise in Glenorchy.
There's a lot of snow coming off the tops up there, see that?
Oh.
They had no choice but to leave Arcadia because Roz needs more support.
What was that like for you?
Oh, pretty devastating, yeah. I was concerned that I could get depressed, but I didn't get depressed at all. I managed to look after myself. I made sure I had good food. I tried to have good sleep and everything like that. I had to really look after myself very well so that I could look after Roz. Once something's happened, if you can't do anything about it, you've got to just accept it.
So you're pretty stoic?
I guess.
Good farming stock.
I suppose so, yeah.
Now, Jim faces a dilemma. What to do with Arcadia Station? He has 5 adult children and 10 grandchildren.
The only way to really satisfy everybody is to sell it. I couldn't give it to one person or sell it to one person, one member of the family, because it wouldn't be fair to the others.
The task of selling this gem falls to real estate agent Baz Smith.
Look, I think everyone that drives past the property wants to buy it, to be honest. Jim has dealt with everyone from the owner of Red Bull to Fabio to famous movie producers who've approached him. They've always wanted to buy the whole property, and it's never been for sale.
It's hard to reach places like Arcadia, these hidden gems that are so popular with overseas investors. But there aren't many of them in private hands that are left to snap up.
Arcadia has a rural visitor zone, meaning a developer could build accommodation for tourists on this property. And that may appeal to foreign buyers.
New Zealand's benefited immensely from some of the overseas people who've bought properties around Queenstown and up through the South Island. They've had finance to do things that nobody else has done.
Foreign capital is often required to actually take these properties from what they are to what they could truly become.
But Baz says an overseas purchase is not a given.
It is a very difficult process for foreigners to purchase in New Zealand these days. I see it much more likely that a wealthy Kiwi or a wealthy Kiwi corporate will purchase this property.
You think that's likely?
I think that's more likely, yeah.
Paradise is one of the most beautiful places on Earth. I haven't really had the finance to really develop it. It's been adequate from us, but for quite a while there's only been 2 people living here. But I know that whoever buys this property will look after it and make Arcadia something more than it is now.
Although Jim no longer lives on the station, he's back here each day to manage the farm.
Looking beautiful.
And he has the company of its only full-time resident, bow.
He's 14 years old. Well, until about a year ago, I used to take him for a 4 or 5 kilometre run every day. But he's just aged like I have, and he's deaf now, that's the trouble. I've developed a bit of sign language with him, so we do a little bit of sign language. He understands.
Recently, Jim learned that Bo has terminal cancer.
We could never take him away from here now. If I leave this place, I think we'd have to just peacefully put him down.
It's hard to imagine this homestead without Jim and without the treasures he has gathered at Arcadia Station.
It's been a huge part of your life, hasn't it?
It has been. Well, it is a big part of my life because, you know, I've been here a long time. Sooner or later, I had to go anyway, so it's now sooner.
So what will it be like when you go down that driveway one last time?
I'll have a load of stuff with me and I'll think, have I left anything behind or what?
That'll be what's on your mind.
Is that bull in the wrong paddock or something like that, you know?
When Jim does leave, a life's worth of memories are going with him.
I'm always going to remember the pleasure I've had out of the place. Instead of being sad that it's not mine now, I can just think of the great times that I've had here.
So as expected, there's been strong interest in the property. 4,000 inquiries, Agent Baz tells us. It's expected to sell for around $20 million. A call for offers closes on March 19. Good to hear too that Bo the dog is still enjoying life at Arcadia.